Well, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us. It's been nearly 3 weeks ago that I made the decision to move the state of Indiana. They're with us. Are you talking to them? Everything good? Okay. Pardon that technical interruption. Thanks for joining us this afternoon. It was nearly 3 weeks ago that I made the decision to move Indiana to stage five and lift some of the restrictions that had been previously put in place. By all accounts, the state was trending in the right direction. In mid-September, you'll recall our seven-day positivity rate had dipped under 4%, and our hospitalizations and census counts were also decreasing. Our state positivity map was largely showing counties in the blue. It's exactly where we want them to be and remain, with low and manageable community spread. I said then, if you'll recall, that we would have to be ever vigilant, even going to stage five. There was a reminder that we had to be ever vigilant about taking the precautions that helped us move to stage five, all that progress, that we needed to be mindful and look to take care of our Hoosier neighbors, whether we knew them or not, by wearing face coverings, by socially distancing, by being careful at events, whether they were small, medium, or large, whether they were inside or even outside our most familiar surroundings like our households, especially as we were moving and are moving into the flu season right now. And temperatures, it's a beautiful day today, we want to make sure that as temperatures get colder and cooler and people start to go indoors more permanently, that we're being very mindful of our surroundings. And so, in short, practicing all those basics, the well-known, proven best practices that work to reduce the odds of contracting or transmitting this very lethal virus. Stage five is not the stage where the checkered flag comes out. Stage five is not an excuse for indifference or irresponsibility, just the opposite. And yet, while there are so many Hoosiers who are practicing these best practices, we just all know, we see with our own eyes, that's not the case for everyone. And I know we're not alone. This is happening all over the world. People are tired of this. People have mask fatigue. People are wanting, yearning, as a matter of fact, to get back to the old days, the good old days, and how we used to socialize, get together very closely. You're even probably tired or pained. It's not an overstatement, as am I, of hearing about the numbers of positive cases and hospitalizations and deaths, and even beyond the physical costs, also the financial costs that are as a result of all of this. But with every day comes reports, I remind you, of a lot of folks not wearing face coverings. Even some of our health professionals, and at, again, large events where there's just zero regard for social distancing, even knowing that is increasing the odds of community spread. In less than a month, our positivity rate has moved from under 4% to where it sits today, 5.3%. We've had a record high number of positive cases reported, and more concerning, the number of hospitalizations is increasing to a level we have not seen since the spring. The good news is, day in and day out, again, I just want to stress this, I do see Hoosiers who are making wise decisions that show that they care and have high regard for others around them. They're wearing masks, they're social distancing, they're reducing the odds by putting others not into peril. They're actually helping us slow the spread and get through this. It turns out it's children at our schools who are showing us how it's done, and the administrators, to be sure, how this can be done safely. But we also, as I allude to, all see Hoosiers who are, again, showing just a disregard for the health of their fellow citizens. And that can mean, ultimately, those actions and inactions can mean whether or not our kids are able to stay in school, in class, receiving that instruction in class, in the classroom. It can also affect the most vulnerable among us, or can affect the rate of those going hungry or homeless, as if this current situation and this coronavirus doesn't exist. Those decisions can directly or indirectly, even not intentionally, again, cost lives. More than 3,609 to be exact as of today. And those decisions, or lack thereof, good decisions, are affecting our quality of life, both short-term and long-term. There's so much about this virus we don't know on every age group. So we want to make sure that, you know, as we are going through each and every day, that we're underscoring the fact that it is, again, our actions or our inactions. And those inactions are costing, just to be blunt, healthcare costs, lost wages, business failures. Don't kid yourself, we're all paying this bill. If the bills come and due, and throwing caution to the wind ultimately ends up costing us all. It is the literal definition of whistling past the graveyard, pretending this isn't around us, and we're not the transmitters of it. Dr. Box and her team remain very concerned that close contact events such as weddings and funerals and the receptions and family events like house parties that come after those events, where people, it's just easier to let your guard down and be more trusting and just assume that the odds aren't there working against you. And then forget about the face mask and the social distancing. Those events are the very events that turn out to be big contributors to our positive cases and illnesses. It's these events that have nothing to do with a 500 capacity limit. Tracing is proving that. We are proving that you can go to a Colts game or a soccer game or school or go shopping, and you can do it safely. The numbers, in fact, have everything to do with how many of us are and aren't letting our guard down, even at smaller events and medium-sized and bigger events, where safety protocols are not put into place or practice or reinforced. Other states, you look around us, other states who have capacity limits of 10 people at some events or venues are still facing surging numbers. This has everything to do, again, I'll say it for the fifth time, has everything to do with our actions and our inactions. It's because too many are ignoring science and are rolling the dice as if, again, somebody's going to pay that bill for us. We can only control what we can control. And in my mind, wearing a mask is a layup. One lady recently wrote me and said that when she sees folks wearing a mask, it reminds her of Hoosier hospitality and kind of our calling card, our caring for others. And there are so many events. Again, they can take place anywhere. That's why we have to be ever vigilant.